Communication is the most important part of teamwork. Involves consistently updating each person and never assuming that everyone has the same information. Second point, delegation. Teams that work well together understand the strength and weakness of each team member, one of the benefits of strong teamwork. The team that leaders and members are adaptive of identifying all aspects of a project is really good for the team. Efficiency. A strong and cohesive team develops systems that allow team to collaborate efficiently to complete tasks in timely manner. Also, we have to always tell our creativity and innovations to the team members, engages in continuous improvement, solves teamwork problems and conflicts. Practice participation is necessary. Working and thinking for the team, not blaming each other if a mistake happens. The leader should not act like a boss, but always asking help for always asking opinions of the team members.
Okay, Drishti Mathur has raised her hand. We need to give her the permission to talk. Yes.
Thank you very much. I completely agree with Anu's point that communication and collaboration are things that are like most essential in the teamwork. Because if you do not communicate properly, you will not be able to get our things well. The more we communicate to our fellow team members, the better work can be done in that. Collaboration is also a big deal. And also with it, team trust is also one very important factor that all the members should have trust within themselves. Thank you.
I agree with Drishti. Collaboration and communication are the roots of teamwork.
Very good. Anyone else? Anyone else? Or shall we ask Anu to continue? Okay. Yes, Siddhartri.
Ma'am, as Drishti and Trisha said, it is very important to have open communication between team members. If open communication is missing, then the team is going to fail. Thank you.
Okay. Yes.
Also,
Shreya, we have Shreya also. Anu, just wait for her. Yes, Shreya, please.
Yes, ma'am, I completely agree with Drishti because there are many people in a team who are shy or introvert persons. So if we'll not ask them for their opinions, so how will we get to know that what are their means, how they think, and maybe their ideas are more greater than the means, more powerful than the extrovert persons?
The captain should ask every team member about their opinions because some of the shy and introvert persons cannot speak their thoughts in the team. Also, how to set up that project or presentation together by every thought and opinion is very important. Also, if the captain is there or not, the team should not only think about himself that he should only get the credit, but also think about the team, that how I have to show my team or I have to highlight them. Thank you.
Thank you, Anu. That was wonderful. We have our second participant, Vandita Upadhyay. Vandita Upadhyay, we would request you to continue with the group discussion.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. Greetings to all. I am Vandita Upadhyay, and today I'll be talking about what I understand by effective teamwork. Teams who are working together to achieve a common goal. It consists of a team leader, the team members, who must work together like a single entity, a single organism, in order to achieve their set objective. What is teamwork? Teamwork is the combined action of a group to achieve their goal. What is effective teamwork? Characteristics of effective teamwork include having a clear direction and common goal, defined roles. What is the role of a leader? The leader has to assign tasks or roles to the members, facilitate cooperation among them, and ensure smooth functioning of the team. Each member has different roles to play. The members have to complete their individual tasks assigned by the leader and get work done. Next, open and honest communication. A team can only function properly if there is a closed loop communication among the members and the leader. That is, if a leader assigns a task to a member, the member has to acknowledge it and report back once the task is completed. Then the leader will acknowledge the member's work. There should be no unnecessary communication or decision making without the leader knowing. Be mutually accountable. When you're in a team, you cannot blame each other for mistakes and failures. You should celebrate success together and recognize contribution made by each member. Collaboration, and lastly, team trust. If these team ethics, basic rules are followed, the team will be able to achieve their objective. Unity is strength. When there is teamwork and collaboration, wonderful things can be achieved. Always remember, teamwork makes the dream work. Thank you so much.
Oh, that was wonderful, Vandita. And there was no counter question from anybody. All the team members, do you support her?
Yes, I totally agree.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that is the whole point. You have to cut her in between and you have to speak, right? That is the whole point of group discussion. Okay, that's fine, but it was very good, Vandita. Now you, now we'll go to the next participant, that is Harshvardhan. And I request everybody, all the participants, to keep your cameras on at all times. That is a must rule of this group discussion. Kindly adhere to the rules. Thank you so much, Harshvardhan. Over to you.
Greetings to all. My name is Harshvardhan. A leader which cannot work with the team is not a perfect leader. A leader must be like something who supports the team and gives equality to all the persons in the team.
Ma'am, actually, I totally agree with Harshvardhan what he said, that the captain should be that much responsible asking its team member for their opinions, because sometimes if we see that the team members or the captain sometimes not agree with each other and the conflicts happen and it affects the presentation and project, whatever they are having with them. Also, I would like to add few points that the captain not only listen them, also how to instruct them, not act like a boss. He should instruct them like his friend, that what should they do. Also assigning their tasks and giving the specific time.
Shubhangi, we'll come to Shubhangi here. Yes, Shubhangi. Shubhangi, you have 30 seconds. You have 30 seconds for your point, then we'll go to the next candidate. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I would like to say that captain should not be exactly like a friend, because captain's duty is to lead people, and captain's duty is to maintain the discipline within the team. So if he acts like a friend, and if he acts even like a friend, he should do that in a good manner, like not exactly like a friend. He should be always a leader and always maintain the discipline and decorum in the team.
Thank you. Thank you, Shubhangi. That was a very well said point. Now we go to the next candidate, Aditi Saxena. Aditi Saxena, over to you.
Yes. Good morning, respected judges and all my fellow students. Today I'm going to discuss on the topic effective teamwork. It is very well said by Isaac Newton that if I have seen further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants. I fully subscribe to the above quote, that alone we can do less, but together we can move the mountain. I hope you all remember the movie Chak De India, and the online teamwork with effective leadership lessons, and where the coach of the Indian girls hockey team completely ruled out of playing for self, and also emphasized on effective teamwork. Effective teamwork hinges on the most important building block, which is healthy communication, to know the potentials of every pillar of the team. Working on internal politics and waiting for the correct moment to use the skills of the team members by the team's leader ensures success. Healthy environment is also an essential element for effective teamwork, where you are surrounded by people who are more smart than you, and they also have a goal of building a compact team with different skills and experiences come together. It is very important to acknowledge that success is the outcome of work done on fundamental aspects, rather than just blindly chasing the
Okay, we'll stop you here. Tanisha has raised the hand. Yes, Tanisha.
Yes, ma'am. I agreed. She said that the team leader should be surrounded with good people, because if he is surrounded with good people, then he has a good vibes and he has good ideas and good vibes. He get these good vibes from those good people which he is surrounded by.
Okay, thank you, Trisha. Your chance. We give you 30 seconds to give your point.
I totally agree with Aditi. Someone has truly said, one can win games, many can win championships.
Okay, very good. So let's go to the next participant. We have Shreya Mishra from 8B. Over to you, Shreya Mishra.
Thank you, teachers, for giving me this opportunity to speak here. Good morning, everyone present over here. I'm Shreya Mishra from class 8B, and I would like to start by stating my view of matter on the topic effective teamwork. As Miss Louisa May Alcott once said, it takes two flints to make a fire. In the same way, effective teamwork is at the heart of every organization's success. Whether you are running a company, a baseball team, a musical band, or any campaign, chemistry makes your team great. One of the main leadership competencies for any organization is the ability to build and lead high-performing teams. This is especially critical for small and medium businesses where people must work closely. Some of the main characteristics for effective teamworks are as follows. First, setting a clear direction, goals, directions, and a clear sense of purpose unify the group. When you have goals, everyone will know.
Okay, Shreya, you have to wait for a minute. Aditi, yes, please. She raised her hand. She has to speak. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I totally agree with Shreya that, like, I'll give an example that COVID-19 has led to many innovations and different ideas. And as she said, something like two friends make one fire. So, yes, like in our school also, the whole team, including the teachers, principal, and the IT department, they all have worked together, and then only it was possible to conduct such good classes.
Lovely. Okay, Ishita, she also raised her hand. Shreya, we have to give her a chance. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. I totally agree with Shreya when she said that for a team to succeed, they should first decide their goal.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Shreya, your time's up, so we will go to the next participant here. Trisha Singh. We have Trisha Singh from class 8.
Thank you.
Over to you. Yes.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Trisha Singh, and I'm going to discuss the topic efficiency of teamwork. Teamwork, any task or activity done in a group with everyone communicating and collaborating with each other. A teamwork is only successful when it contains these main characteristics: cooperation, leadership, communicating, collaborating, listening, etc. In all of these, communicating and collaborating are known as roots of teamwork. Someone has truly said, one can win games, many can win championships. One of the challenges in teamwork is difference of opinion, which can be solved by leadership. Teamwork is necessary at some times because it helps solving many problems. For example, take the story of two brothers. When one was not able to break a bundle of sticks, he called for help to his brother, and they both did it together. This shows if you can't do it alone, you can do it together. Some of the most important things in teamwork is communicating freely, encourage different opinions.
Okay, Trisha, I'll cut you short here. Shreya Mishra, yes, wants to add to something. Yes, Shreya.
Yes, ma'am. I totally agree with Trisha. She gave an example of sticks. Like, if we have one stick, one can break easily. But if we have a lot of sticks, a bundle of sticks, no one can break it easily. Because that's where teamwork is have a great importance in our lives.
Very good. Thank you. I'll go to Drishti. Drishti, your chance, please. Siddhartvi, please keep the cameras open. Vaishnavi, it is a request and it is a rule. So you need to keep it open. Switch it on, please. Thank you. Yes. Yes, Rishti.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. Even I agree with the story that was said by the participant that the bundle of sticks, one, that if we stay together, we stay in unity, then we can do many things. There have been many stories like this, such as the cow and the wolf one. And when the cows were in a herd, they were not able to be killed by the lion. But when each of them was separated, then they were easily killed by the lion. Since what is the comparison of cow and lion? So definitely teamwork gives huge things, because if we are in a team, like if we are separated, then we get single ideas, and those single ideas can create one presentation. But if there are dozen of ideas, we can take one presentation with huge number of ideas. So that really makes a difference. Thank you.
Thank you. We will give a chance to Sanskriti because the rest of them have already got a chance once. Sanskriti, yes, please. Shubhangini, yes, will come to you later.
Yes, ma'am, I agree with her because unity is strength. When anything is in group, then no one can break it or no one can destroy the strength in them. And that is why I agree with Prisha.
Okay, thank you. We'll go to the next participant. Tanisha, you can all keep your views for the next participant, okay? Tanisha, are you there?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, please.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Tanisha. And today I want to speak about the topic efficient teamwork. Teamwork. Individually, we are a drop of water. But together, we form a big ocean. It is a famous quote said by Steve Jobs. Great things in business can never be done by one person. They're done by a group of people. Team is the fuel that allows common people to attain uncommon results. Team have some basic needs that must be fulfilled and acknowledged. If you expect your team members to
experience their dreams. Tanisha, wait, Aditi is there? Yes, Aditi. Yes. Aditi, over to you. Yeah.
Ma'am, I totally agree with Tanisha that in a team we can be.
Okay, I think she's frozen out there. Tanisha, you can continue maybe. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, am I audible?
You're audible now, yes. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I was saying that I totally agree with Tanisha that in a team we can lead to very uncommon results which are very nice and something which is very different. So, like, I would like to give an example. Like, team of the health workers, police and many others have tackled the first wave of the virus, coronavirus, very nicely. And I think this the second wave, they will also tackle it.
Okay.
I totally agree with Aditi, as in also in this situation, many countries are helping India, even though it's spread all over the globe.
Okay, fine. I will not agree to that, but I'm not a participant anyway. So, Drishti Madhur, over to you. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the participant said that big companies should not be started by one person, but that I think that is false because there are many companies such as, let me give some examples, such as Instapaper, Dev Ditko, NewsBlur, and one of the most common, KFC. KFC was like one of the biggest ones that the person who started it, he ran it for ages. And now it has there that they have so many branches here. But first it was a street, vendor, and he so sold it. And then also he got such a big deal that everybody knows here, KFC.
But that was a solo achievement that he got
always
it.
Important. That teamwork is always important for big businesses.
But yeah, that was a solo achievement that he got it. And actually this line is not about only teamwork, but I want to say that like it's talking about business, and in most things like where teamwork is important, the person should collide and should
Okay, Tanisha, we will give chance to Shubhangini here. Okay.
Ma'am, actually I wanted to cut Drishti's point. Like if there is one person, he only might have only one idea, he only might have only one perspective. But when he works as a team, he has a bunch of ideas and he also gets to know a different perspective of different people.
That is
true.
Okay, everybody, you know the rules. We know the rules. We will go to the next participant. 2 minutes are over for her. The next participant is Vishesh Patel. Okay, Vishesh, are you there? Do we have the next participant? Do we have Vishesh here? Okay, let's go to the next participant, Shubhangini Singh. Yes, please, over to you. Over to you.
Good morning to one and all present here. Today, I, Shubhangini Singh, is going to express my thoughts on the topic teamwork. We all might experience working in a team or at least know about teamwork. Thus, I would not like to go in detailed description Instead, I would like to express the importance of teamwork through a story or two. We all may have heard the story of an old man who was about to take his last breath, and then he thought to teach his sons an important lesson. So he called his four sons and told them to bring two twigs each. When he said to break one twig, everyone broke it easily. But when he said to just tie all the twigs and just break the bundle of twigs, then nobody was able to break it. So that's
okay, Adhiraj. Shubhangi, I'll cut you short here. Adhiraj, he wants to make a point.
I totally agree with Shubhangi, see, as this story we all have heard, and it was very popular story, and it also has a moral that unity strength, and teamwork always have a unity. So I totally agree with her.
Okay, very good. Shubhangini, over to you. Still have 1 minute left.
Yes, ma'am. And I would also like to give one more example about a very popular Bollywood film which was released in 2004 and also was nominated for Oscars, Lagan. It is just a very simple story and also just a very popular story about two teams playing cricket. But what makes that movie interesting is that they were fighting against the experts of a team. Still they won. And
okay, individually, okay. Shubhangi, Anu Pandey is waiting for a long time. We will give her a chance to her. Okay.
Yeah. Ma'am, I totally agree with Shubhangi. As she has given the example of the movie, it shows that if we are having any problem in the team, but if we work together, we can succeed.
Okay, thank you so much. Shubhangi, your time's up. All right, Siddhartha, you want to make a point here? We'll come to you because we never gave you a chance before. Come on, Siddhartha, over to you.
As Shubhangini said to us and gave the example of the movie, I would like to add that if a team is to reach its potential, each member must be willing to coordinate the goal for the welfare of the team.
Okay, thank you so much, Siddhartha. We have the next participant from 8D, Sanskriti Mishra.
Good morning. Myself, Sanskriti Mishra. There is a famous saying, united we stand, divided we fall. It basically means that without teamwork, nothing great can be achieved. We all know that the effective the teamwork is, the attractive the result it gives. But the question here comes...
Okay, Aditi, Sanskriti, Aditi wants to say, Aditi, all the participants, make sure when you give an argument or you support with an example. Support with a concrete evidence, okay? Yes, please, Aditi.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I totally agree with Sanskriti because, like, there was a movie, Mission Mangal. In that also, the Mission Mangal was successful even though there were unexperienced team members in the group, except the two. So, and still they worked together and the Mangalyaan landed on the Mars successfully because the leader of that team had given the members a bit of negative and positive, both type of pressure, because negative pressure, if you give someone a negative pressure, then with anger, he will think that and now I have to do it and I'll show this person that I can also do it, and it can also do it much better.
Thank you. We'll go over to Vandita probably. Vandita, yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I disagree with what Sanskriti said. She said that great things can only be achieved when one works in a team. That is not true. There are many soloists out there who have achieved great things without working in a team. Instagram influences all over the world. Greta Thunberg, Malala Yousafzai.
Is
the name more?
Okay, Drishti, over to you. Drishti, over to you.
Yes, sir. I agree with Vandita's point and I disagree with Samstiti's point on this, that she said that nothing great can happen with teamwork, but that's false. Let's take an example of PewDiePie. Like, he is like second because first is T-Series, second most followed YouTuber, and he is the only one who does the thing. And there are so many, like Vandita said, Malala Yousafzai, and so many there are who have not done anything in teamwork. They started the campaign or the organization themselves, worked for years, and then people came back.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. We still have 2 seconds left for Sanskriti. Let her complete her discussion. Yes.
Question of Vandita and Drishti. that she said that many soloists have also achieved great success, but when you work in a team and achieve a great success, the happiness which you have is more than when you achieve anything so by doing anything individually. So when you do anything in team, it is even more happier.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Sanskriti. Your time's up. That's the part of group discussion. We need to keep the tab on time, right? Okay, so we have Siddharthvi Singh now, our next participant from class 8D. Over to you. Siddharthvi, are you there? Yep, over to you, please. Thank you.
Good morning, respected teachers and my dear friends. I'm Siddharthvi, and today I'm going to present my views on effective teamwork. Teamwork is basically defined as an activity of working together with numerous people. But as today's session is all about effective teamwork, then the work of a team can be made effective if members do and contribute their level best. There are several characteristics of an effective team. A team has a common shared goal. Open communication between members is also an important aspect, and if not so, then the team will fail. There must be diversity, so that the members bring different opinions, skills, and experiences to the team. Trust between teammates is also very important, because if trust is missing, then members will worry among themselves and the work will suffer. Team members should have mutual respect for each other. Disrespecting can cause animosity and tension in the team. One should set aside their prejudices and beliefs in order to make an effective team. For instance, Bollywood movies and Hollywood movies such as Bold, Lagan, and Any Given Sunday describe effective teamwork in the best way. If we also see in real life, then the Indian cricket...
Okay, Drishti, Drishti wants to cut you short here. Yes, Drishti, please. Over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. I completely agree with Siddharthi's point, especially the Lagan one. Lagan is not only an example of effective teamwork, it's also an example of effective leadership. Like, what is the role of the leader? They're important role, they motivate the team, ensure their success, they include goals, practices. All that things was done by the Lagans, the leader.
Okay.
Motivated the people.
Okay, thank you. And Shubhangini, over to you.
Yes, ma'am, I would like to, I support Drishti, and as she said that not only the leader made them win, he also made the people who don't even knew what was cricket, made them win the match, and individually the players were nothing compared to the opponent players, but still they won by a little bit of practice and a focused goal.
Okay, thank you. Shreya, over to you. Over to you, Shreya. We give you 15 seconds, please. Hurry up. Yeah. Shreya, you're not audible to us. You have to unmute yourself, darling. Unmute yourself, Shreya. Okay. Aditi, over to you. We are running short of time. Aditi,
yes,
over
ma'am.
To you. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, even I agree with Drishti. Because it was the same in the movie Chhalang also. At the last part, when there was the tournament of life was going on, and that also the team which was not so much trained, that also worked together, focused a lot, and they won.
Okay, thank you. Now we have our next participant, Drishti Mathur from AD.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Mathur, over to you. Yes.
A very good morning to honorable judges, educators, and my fellow friends. I, Drishti Mathur, today will speak on the topic efficient teamwork. The basis of team effectiveness was identified by J. Richard Hackman, who was the pioneer in the field of organizational behavior. He, after a long time research, found that what matters most to collaboration is not the personalities, not the attitudes, not the behavioral styles of team members. Instead, what teams need to thrive are the certain enabling conditions. Effective teamwork basically means a synergistic way of working with each person committed and working towards a common, a shared goal.
Drishti, I'll stop you here. Shubhangini, it's your turn, please. You want to
speak? Yes, ma'am. I disagree on her one point. She said that it doesn't matter the behavior of the participants, but that matters the team a lot. If the team members are not serious to their goal, not serious to what they want to achieve, and how hard the team leader works, and how hard the other participants work, But if only just even one, if one participant also is not focused, then it pressurizes the team a lot, and it can just harm the consequences of the
performance. Team. Performance, you can use the word. Okay, here, Anu, I'll give you a chance because you've been waiting for a long time. Anu, please add to the discussion.
Yes, ma'am, I totally agree with Shubhangi. We can take example of our school only, that sometimes the students are not focused towards their studies, and sometimes because of them, the result of the class goes down. So I totally agree to Shubhangi.
Okay, we come to Siddhartri. Siddhartri?
Ma'am, I disagree from Drishti's point, as she said that behavior doesn't matter. But what if a participant has no commitment to the team? Commitment mostly matters. What if they leave the team in between? And one of the important aspects of teamwork is the cooperation, and it is an important element.
Okay, Drishti wants to counteract here. Yes, Drishti, over to you. You have 50 to 20 seconds max.
Well, like what everybody is saying, that behavior, I totally say that behavior is not the behavior you're taking it that way. That a behavior is like, the behavior which I mean here is like how they act, not how they want. Like, Anu gave an example of the class. So in the class, if one person, like if you consider the group discussion here, are all the people involved in here in the group discussion, is the whole class here? No. Only the people who are willing to get this, who are willing to be in the group discussion are here. There are 3 to 4 people, that's it. Out of 32 students, only 4 people are here because they want their thing and their behavior matters. Their behavior do not matter because obviously if they are willing here, then they definitely
okay. Want to thank you. Thank you, Drishti. So that was quite a solid point from your side. We'll go to the next participant, Adhiraj. Rest of you, please keep your questions ready. Adhiraj, over to you.
Yes. Coming together is beginning, keeping together is progress, and working together is success. Effective teamwork also means good teamwork in a way of working with several people in a group for a specific goal or target. When people are grouped together, the strength of unity can make any work easy for them, no matter if the work is even though impossible to complete. Strength of unity can make us achieve any goal. Effective teamwork makes us achieve only when there is unity, trust, honesty, teamwork, and great
okay. Adhiraj, I'll stop you here. We have Siddhartri raising her hand and Shubhangini. 10 seconds each. Please keep, quickly tell your points. Siddhartri, over to you first.
Ma'am, I agree to Adhiraj's point. And if real life, we see an example from a very well-known band, the Beatles. Yeah. They also started from a group of members, and now you see that they are touching the heights of success.
Thank you so much. Shubhangini, over to you.
Yes, ma'am, like the Drishti gave us the point, like some only 4 students are joining out of 32. So, but if now only 4 students are joining, then the...
Okay, Shubhangini, we have already moved forward towards Adhiraj. So here we'll not be discussing Drishti's point anymore. Right, we'll go to Aditi. Aditi, what do you want to say? You raised your hand.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I wanted to say that I agree with Adhiraj because pressure in the team acts as a catalyst because then you find out new ways to tackle different situations, and working in a team is much more easier than working individually.
Thank you so much, Adhiraj. Your time's up. I'm very sorry. There was a lot of reputation. A lot of involvement of other members in your speech. Yeah, okay, thank you. Ishita, it's your chance now. Over to you, Ishita. Ishita, if you would take time, we can go to the next participant.
Hi. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I'm here.
Yeah, all right. Please go ahead.
Hi, I'm Ishita Mahapatra from AT, and I'm here to express my views on effective teamwork. Effective teamwork is when a team tries to get finest or most effective output of a task. Each member contributes, suggesting their ideas and analysis in attempt to not just achieve the goal, but accomplished even more than that.
I think, Ishita, we are not I able to hear you properly.
Be effective.
Okay.
Give us
participants, can you hear her properly? Is she audible enough?
Ma'am,
Okay.
Life doesn't have many opportunities, but when you get them, ma'am, can you hear me?
Ishita, I'm really sorry, we're not able to hear you. Judges, Roli ma'am and Samriddhi ma'am, are you able to hear her? Is she audible, ma'am?
Not properly. Clear voice nahi aa rahi hai Ishita.
Some echoing voice is echoing. Ishita, try once more. Just let's try. Speak up something.
Effective teamwork is when a team tries to get the finest or most effective output of a task. Each member contributes, suggesting their ideas and analysis in attempt to not just achieve the goal, but accomplish even more than that. Why should teamwork be effective? Life doesn't give us many opportunities, but when we get an opportunity, we have to make the best of it. This can be done by working as a team in an effectual manner. A successful team should have a good leader who can control and maneuver the team, be decisive, and believe in his or her team members. Members in a team should be able to share their ideas, questions, and knowledge.
Okay, Ishita, we have Aditi. Ishita, sweetheart, we have Aditi. Yes, thank you, Aditi.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I disagree with Ishita on the point that the leader should control the members of the team. The leader should not control them. The leader should listen to the team members. He should take their points in the project or whatever work they are doing, but he should not control them as a boss, because he is also of the same category. He is also a person. He is not something which is out of the box, but he should not control them. He should take their views also.
Okay, thank you. Adhiraj, I'll give you a chance because you never got a chance to speak when it was actually your turn.
I also disagree with Ishita Mopar that we should not control our members. If we are a leader, so we should not control, we should help them. And we should also not assign tasks only to them. We should also assign tasks to ourselves also. Means to the leader should also assign tasks to himself also. So that he could also contribute and he could also help his teammates and go towards the success with his team.
Thank you. We'll go to Shreya right now. Shreya Mishra, you want to add something?
Ma'am, I disagree with Ishita because controlling and leading are two other words and they mean totally different. Because if you will lead someone, so they'll have a means, they'll do some things under you as you want. That is controlling, and leading is making their thoughts and mixing your thoughts and their thoughts together is leading.
Okay, thank you so much. We'll go to Vaishnavi next.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, everyone present here. Myself, Vaishnavi Singh of class 8D is going to...
Vaishnavi,
Vaishnavi, please open your camera.
Ma'am, actually, I have opened my camera.
Okay, we're not able to see her. Okay, fine, Vaishnavi, continue.
See, ma'am, teamwork. One of the most important that everyone should follow in is teamwork. Learn is teamwork. Teamwork is one of the bare minimum requirements for any organization to function and achieve all its goals. One of the most significant advantages of working in team is that work gets divided between all the group members when the work is shared. All the members are going to equal amounts of jobs.
Okay, Vaishnavi Sweetie, Tanisha wants to add something to it, please.
Yes, ma'am, I totally agree to her point that no one should be unequally treated. Everyone should get the same amount of work that one is getting. Even the leader should work, because if the leader isn't working, then he will not become a leader, he will become a boss.
Thank you. Okay, Anu Pandey, it's your chance now. Yeah.
I totally agree what all the participants said, that actually when we get so much burden, so in pressure, we cannot make that beautiful presentation or project that we can make without pressure and burden.
Okay, last point, we'll come over to Shubhangini. Shubhangini, we'll end the discussion with you.
Ma'am, yes. I will not say that work should be equally distributed. Instead, it should be categorized like who does the work better. Like, it should be equally distributed, but in such a manner. Like, if we give an artist, ma'am, if we divide the work in such a way, if we give an artist a work to do math, so he will not do that way, though the work would be equal. But instead of being equal, it should be distributed in such a way that all participants get the work in which they are the best.
Okay, that was a very good, we are actually running out of time, and that was a very good point to end the group discussion. Over to Roli ma'am and Samriddhi ma'am, we can conclude the group discussion. Over to the judges.
It was taking time to unmute. It was a really, really good competence. Thank you, children, you have taught me a lot of things today. Many things, like what teamwork is actually, and how does the head of the team should work. That's also very important. Like rightly just now somebody said that we have to be a part of your team, not the leader, not the boss. Yes, the team which is winning or making good, achieving goals has to work hand in hand. It has to be a real team for listening to others. Thank you, children, it was really good, good. Thank you, Tanushree ma'am, for making me a part of it. And as far as the results are concerned, I will be having a tough time to decide.
मैं अधिराज and हर्षवर्धन दोनों को बहुत बहुत मुबारकबाद इसलिए दूंगी कि कम से कम इस ग्रुप डिस्कशन में दो बॉयज दिखे मुझे, ठीक है. और सबसे अच्छी चीज कि मुझे गर्ल्स पावर दिखी, ठीक है. और वास्तव में जब डिस्कशन हो रहा था तनुश्री मैम, तो बहुत सारी चीजें जो मतलब ऐसा लग रहा था कि बच्चे आज हम लोगों को एक नया लेसन पढ़ा रहे हैं. बहुत अच्छा लगा मुझे. और दृष्टि, बहुत अच्छा बोला बच्चे तुमने, और वंदिता एज वेल अच्छा बोलती ही है. और अधिराज को मुझे लगता है अगर थोड़ा सा टाइम और मिलता तो अधिराज बहुत अच्छा बोलता.
Yes, ma'am.
और एक चीज तुम लोगों की मैंने देखी कि प्रैक्टिस सेशन में जो तुम लोगों को बताए गए थे रूल्स ये हैं, तो तुम लोग मतलब जो तुम्हारा जो पार्टिसिपेंट जो है वो अच्छा बोल रहा था, तुम लोगों ने उसे कट करने की पूरी कोशिश की. मजा आया मुझे इसमें, ठीक है. तुम लोगों ने कट इसलिए किया कि हाँ भाई पॉइंट्स तुम्हें मिले, अच्छी तरह समझा. और तनुश्री मैम थैंक यू सो मच, एक आपने मौका दिया इसका हमें कि हम सुने और हम इसको जज करें.
थैंक यू.
बच्चे अगर जितनी बातें तुम लोगों ने बोली है ना, अगर इनको फॉलो करोगे तो वास्तव में एक बहुत अच्छी लीडर बन के सामने आओगे. थैंक यू.